I think, you know, the first very important thing to do is to also acknowledge that on the issue of economic social rights of particularly poor people in China, 400 million people have been lifted out of poverty, and I think it's very important to acknowledge that. If we could have a debate as to whether the means that were used were absolutely right or not, but the fact is that, you know, that has happened. The second thing, I think, is to also acknowledge that, you know, China is not a monolith. You know, we have this idea about China, but, you know, those of you who've lived, I mean, you've lived in China, and people who know anything about China will say that it's a very complicated and diverse internal situation. So you have a lot of churning happening inside China right now. Young people are becoming much more aware. They're more exposed to the internet. We have more and more dissidents, Charter 88. All of these groups are, you know, it's real. It's happening there. And finally, also a very important reality is that China is now coming out of its own boundaries. You know, they're investing in Africa. They're becoming real active players on the global stage. So I think the way for Amnesty is to, on the one hand, of course, to be uncompromising in our critique of their behavior in relation to civil and political rights, but also to, I think, you know, have a very constructive engagement with them that now that they're operating on the international stage, they will have to, you know, abide by international standards. They'll be held to the same standards of accountability as everybody else, which I think they have not had to deal with that in the past.
Has Amnesty got bridges with the Chinese civil society?
Well, we are, you know, just like everybody else, we have an office in Hong Kong, and we are, you know, we are working on China for a long time. So, and you know, there's a lot of Chinese diaspora, and there's a lot of Chinese students who are studying all over the world. So, I mean, we have bridges in that sense. But internet is, you know, the reality is that people are looking at it more and more these days. I mean, Amnesty doesn't work in a surreptitious way. We don't go into countries without the permission of the government. So we don't do that in principle. So we only go in if there is permission from the government. So we've had one discussion with the Chinese government a couple of years ago, and, you know, we hope that we can have more discussions in the coming period. It's not going to be very easy. It's full of challenges, but I think it's very important that we do have a conversation with them.